All right, welcome back, everybody. Time for today's Creative Living segment, and nobody makes the studio smell better than Chef Lori. But today, we are cooking a little bit lighter in the new year, and you know, Chef Lori's mantra is make a lot of one thing and then make three meals out of it. Yep. So today, it's cabbage.
Yes, it is. I know most people don't do a lot with cabbage, but it is same family as broccoli and cauliflower, so you know it's good for you, right? And the neat thing about cabbage, it lasts in your refrigerator for so long, okay? So it's not like when you buy lettuce, a lot of times it goes bad before you can use it up, right? Cabbage is not like that. So I have in here, we're going to do fish tacos today, but we're going to make a fresh slaw. And you probably won't use all your cabbage, right? So then the next episode we'll use some more, and the next episode we'll use some more.
For another dish.
Right, right. Or you could take a shortcut and buy it in a bag, but this is using fresh cabbage, okay? So what we have in here is this beautiful purple cabbage, right?
Did you just buy a head of it and shred it yourself?
I did.
Okay.
I did. And also we have in there the Napa cabbage, which is a Chinese cabbage.
Okay.
Okay? And so I'm going to have you make the slaw.
So what's this? Green peppers?
No, that is jalapeno. So you're going to not want to touch that. Remember, if you're cutting those up yourself, you want to have gloves on because
this is the real deal.
Right. So we're going to put lime juice, right? And
fresh.
Some salt. That was fresh, yep. And then some garlic. That's all fine. Okay, and then we're just making a small batch here, and then maybe half of that.
Okay.
I probably made extra. How are you doing over there?
What is this?
I'm good. I just flipped it.
What is this? Cilantro.
Oh, cilantro. Okay,
okay. So you're going to mix that up, and then it will turn out wonderful. So in there, I also put a little red onion, so you have that color. Look at you go. Beautiful.
See, if I can do this, everybody, you can do this.
Right?
All right, what's Elaine doing?
Okay, and so over here, we have cod that we cut into strips. You can use just about any white fish that you want, and it really does good. So it takes about 2 minutes aside, so it's going to take you about 4 minutes to cook this up. We have a lot of the marinade. There's a recipe for the homemade marinade.
Smells so good.
Doesn't it? Yeah, it turned out well. So I put it in just 30 minutes. So I make the marinade, throw the fish in there, make the slaw, then you're ready for tacos, right?
So, and you can use any white fish if you like a mahi or a cod.
Yeah, okay. right. Whatever you want, you really can. And so just make sure that you get it up to the correct temp. But you can just kind of tell when it flakes and when it turns all white then.
Okay.
You know
then it's done.
Okay. Yes,
fish intimidates me. I don't know why.
Same. Okay.
Right. So it's not, 2 minutes aside, and it's probably overdone at that point. But you can always take the temp, too. I have a thermometer for you, so you can do that. And so I'm going to talk a little bit about the tortillas. So I love corn tortillas. And I go to the Mexican food store and buy them because they make them really fresh.
Yeah,
love them that way. And then I put them right on the gas stove and flip them. See how that's got that little bit of brown on there? And you're cooking them that way, and it's got a little bit of char. You're not frying them, so you're not getting that oil.
So they'll still fold.
Yes. Yeah. So they're cooked. So and then I put mango on here because I love the mango sweetness with the tartness of this fresh slaw. Isn't that beautiful?
It is so pretty.
It really is looking really nice.
We're at 130.
Okay, we need a little bit more yet.
All right. That's the chunkiest piece of fish.
Right. Okay, that's good.
Always measure the chunkiest.
Yes, right. And so this is some of the things that went in the marinade. We have paprika, chili powder, and cumin, a little bit of salt. And then we put some olive oil in there, and I put some fresh garlic in there. And you guys can't smell it, but it really...
It does smell so good.
Yeah.
And Chef Lori, last time you were here, you debuted your new website.
Yes.
So how is that going? That is still up and running?
It is. It's really fun. I'm trying to get as many recipes up there as I can, but we did put this one up last night, too. And we're getting to the point now where, like the next recipe I do for the next episode, I have links. So, like, if you don't know how to cut your onion, if you don't know how to segment an orange, I have that on there. So it's like, if I talk about, like, how to cook a tortilla. So I'm getting there. I'm putting more stuff on there. So, because there's a lot of stuff I learned in culinary school I didn't know before I went there.
Well, that's just it. I mean, we have, like, these exotic recipes, but you really, like, kind of, I hate to say this, dumb it down for those of us who don't know what we're doing
well,
in the kitchen.
And it's not that hard once you learn how. I mean, how hard was that?
Right.
So let's put a little coleslaw on the side here.
On the tortilla, though,
there
right?
There you go. Yep. And you can make this also if you're just having fish on a Friday night.
What number are we shooting for with our...
145.
All right, we're good here.
All right, so we're going to put some of that fish on there.
This piece can go on.
All right.
I'll take these other two little guys.
They're done for sure. Right. Okay. And then I also like... It depends on how spicy you like it, but I like a little...
Little kick, huh?
Little kick on there, yes. All right. So should I cut a piece for you guys?
I'm just going to pick up the whole thing.
Are you?
I'm going for
it. Okay, go ahead. All right. She's going to try it.
One of us is going to have to talk, so you go ahead and take a bite and let us know what you think.
Oh, my goodness.
Tastes as good as it smells in here.
Even better.
All right, yeah. So, and it's because it's got all that fresh stuff in it.
Yes.
It's got the fresh cilantro, which is good for you. It's got fresh cabbage, which is good for you. And I love a little kick of jalapeno.
Well, I can't wait to see what we do with leftover cabbage. But for these recipes, head to LoriFernandez.com. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.